أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونشكره ونصلي ونسلم على حبيب إله العالمين حافظ سره ومبلغ رسالته الرسول المسدد المصطفى الأمجد المحمود الأحمد أبي القاسم محمد وبآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات الله عليهم أجمعين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم ومنكر فضائلهم وغاصب حقوقهم من الأولين والآخرين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المجيد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا تطلى عليهم آيات الرحمن خروا سجدا وبقيا آمنا بالله وصدق الله العلي العظيم صلوا على محمد وآل محمد The purpose of our congregation this evening is to revere the holy personality, the Holy Lady Zainab alayha salam. When we say that we have gathered here to revere her, to focus on her spiritual qualities, to remember her, to discuss about her, to appreciate her, to value her, the personality itself, the personality of Holy Lady Zainab alayha salam. But then question arises that who told me to revere her? Why should I revere her? Why should I appreciate her? Why should I discuss about Holy Lady Zainab alayha salam? She was born in fifth year after Hijrah, and this is 1438, so approximately 1433 years ago, approximately 14 centuries ago. That is long ago. Why should I be discussing about this holy personality tonight? This is the purpose of our congregation. That is why we have met here today, this evening, so that we, you and I, discuss about this personality. But then is it necessary? Why so? Why should I be discussing about her? And why should you be listening to me about Holy Lady Zainab alayha salam? The answer is that this is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the tradition and the method of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you open Quran Majid, you will find in Surah Maryam, Surah Maryam is chapter number 19. And tonight, most of the verses which I shall be reciting and I shall be discussing will be about Surah Maryam. It's a coincidence. It's a mini research, but I just came up with many verses of Surah Maryam. And you will find that in Surah Maryam, this is chapter 19, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in verse number 2, initially it starts with huruf muqatti'at, kaf, ha, ya, ayn, swad. The second verse of Surah Maryam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that dhikru rahmati rabbika abdahu zakariya. Quran says that this is a mention of the holy, this is the mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a holy mention, it's a sacred mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards his servant Zakariya. You will see that in Surah Maryam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes constantly, continuously mentions personalities. And then it's not only that he says, he mentions them, but then he says, wadhkur, and you remember them, mention them. The way we have come to remember Zainab alayha salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes in Surah Maryam. He says that wadhkur. Now, you will find that the second verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this is a mention. Which mention? A holy mention. A sacred mention. He says that dhikru rahmati rabbika abdahu Zakariya. This is a mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from your Lord towards Zakariya. So it is rahmah towards Zakariya that I'm mentioning him. Listen carefully, O Muhammad. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Zakariya initially in Surah Maryam, that he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nida'an khafiyya, with humility, with humbleness. He prayed in mihrab that, O Lord, you all know, you must have heard this. I'll go very quickly because we don't have enough time tonight. He says that I'm not blessed with children. Bless me with a child so that he should be an heir. He should be an inheritor of Ale Yaqub. He should be an inheritor of the family of Yaqub. My wife is barren, I'm very old, my bones are weakened, bless me a child. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we accepted his prayer and we blessed him with Yahya. You go along, come to verse number 16, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ إِذِنْ تَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَقَانًا شَرْقِيًّا. This is verse number 16. You will find that here also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes that wadhkur, the way we have come to remember Zainab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes us to remember his personalities. And what word does Allah use? Allah uses wadhkur fil kitabi Maryam idhin tabazat min ahliha makanan sharqiyya, which means that remember her. Talk about Maryam, Allah emphasizes. He says, when she withdrew herself from her family and she went to the house eastwards. Then again, Allah talks about Maryam. He says that when she was blessed with Isa, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that when Isa was in the lap of his mother, he says that, Qala inni Abdullah atani al-kitab. وَجَعَلَنِ نَبِيًّا. You all know this. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Maryam that Isa said that وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدْتُ يَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ هَيَّ. Then Allah, he says that, and peace be upon me on that day when I was born, when I will die and I will be resurrected. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says ذَلِكَ إِسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمْ قَوْلَ الْحَقِّ. Allah says that this is the statement of Isa, and this is the statement of truth. Qawl al-haq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Maryam, and he says that you go on mention Maryam in your gatherings. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes. He says in Surah Maryam, verse number 41. Allah says, Wadhkur fil kitabi Ibrahim. Innahu kana siddiqan nabiyya. Allah says, mention about Ibrahim. Why? Then he says, because he was the truthful and he was a prophet. Innahu kana siddiqan nabiyya. Then again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about Ibrahim. He says that, you know what? He stood against his father Azar. He stood against him and he said that, why do you worship the idols? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wadhkur fil kitabi Musa. You will find that after a few verses, again Allah emphasizes that speak, mention, remember, wadhkur, remember in the book. Whom shall we remember? Musa. Allah says, wadhkur fil kitabi Musa. Innahu kana mukhlasan. He was sincere. Innahu kana mukhlasan. He's freed from impurities. See, you have got mukhlis and you've got mukhlas. Allah does not say that Musa is mukhlis. Allah says that innahu kana mukhlasan. He was freed by Allah from impurities. He was a masoom. Innahu kana mukhlasan. Then Allah says that wa kana rasulan nabiyya. And he was a messenger and a prophet. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says again, wadhkur fil kitabi Ismail. He says, mention Ismail. Wadhkur fil kitab Ismail. You will appreciate that after mentioning every personality, Allah gives a small quality, one quality of that personality. He says, wadhkur fil kitab Ismail. Innahu kana, Allah says, sadiq al wa'd. He was true of his promises about Ismail. Allah says, he says that innahu kana sadiq al wa'd wa kana rasulan nabiyya. Then he says, وَكَانَ يَأْمُرُ أَهْلَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ وَكَانَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ مَرْضِيًّا. He used to enjoin his family, Ismail. He used to enjoin his family so that they should pray and they should pay poor rent. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was well pleased with him. Through this verse, we come to know that it is the task of the head of the family to enjoin his family to pray and to pay the poor rent. It is not the task of a resident alim to pull the youths or to pull the people to come towards the mosque. It is the task of a father. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says openly, he says that وَكَانَ يَأْمُرُ أَهْلَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that he enjoined his family so that they should pray and pay poor rent, and Allah was well pleased with him. It is not, if you say that Molana, youths are quiet, they are lost, so who shall be blamed? If the youths are lost, do you want to blame resident alim? Do you want to blame the Jamaat? Do you want to blame the MC? Do you want to blame other people? Do you want to blame the madrasa? Do you want to blame the teachers of the madrasa? No, it is the parents themselves. It is whose responsibility? Whose responsibility? It is the responsibility of the parents. Take example of Nuh. Nabi Nuh alayhi salam, who could be better than the prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And that also a prophet like Nuh, who did tabligh 950 years according to Quran. But he, what is the responsibility of an alim? It is to convey the message. He cannot force, he cannot impose. He has to convey the message. Yes, وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغِ. But he cannot force. Nuh was also muballigh. When he saw that his son is drowning, and he warned his son, he said that, oh my son, the calamity will inflict you, it will afflict you. You will be carried away with the floods. You will drown, oh my son, come. But the son refused. The son said that, no, oh father, I will climb the tree. Let me climb the tree. Canaan said that I won't come to your ark. And then Nuh prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, after all, he was a father. He said that, oh Allah, this is my son. I pray for him. Allah says, innahu laysa min ahlik. This is Quran. This is not from your ahl. Why? What is the reason? Innahu amalun ghayru salih. Because he doesn't have amal salih. This is Surah Hud, verse number 46. Innahu amalun ghayru salih. In Kiswahili, I can see many people speaking Kiswahili here. In Kiswahili, they say, abiria chunga mzigo wako. Which means that the passenger has to be mindful of his own luggage. When you travel, you have got valuable items with you. If you do not take care of your own valuable items, what do you expect? You did not take care of your valuable items, your precious items, and then when if it is stolen, it has gone away from your hands, from your authority, now you sit and blame the cabin crew, and you sit and blame the traveling agents, you sit and blame the pilot, and other people, that it is their fault. It is not my, first of all, you yourself, are you coming to the mosque? You yourself don't come to mosque, you don't come for salah, then you want your children to come for salah. How is it possible, my friend? You yourself need to come. If you plant something else, and then you expect something else, what you have planted, you will get. It all depends upon yourself. We have got here the pamphlets, visit my mosque. Somebody said in the foyer that, Maulana, we should have another pamphlet for our people. This is for those guests who will come on open day, inshallah, on Sunday. We should have visit your mosque. Visit your mosque. Come to your mosque. This is your mosque. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. If you do not come often to the mosque, then you will be brought to the mosque. Quran says. And for those who are coming in Nawaz-e-Jumma, you are listening this surah every Friday. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ. You will be sent back. He won't ask you. When the time comes, he will take you back. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ فَيُنَبِّيُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And he is going to inform you, what have you done? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wazkur fil kitabi Ismail. Allah says that mention Ismail. Wazkur fil kitabi Idris. Mention about Idris. Warafa'anahu makanan aliyah. Verse number 57. And we raised him in a high station. We exalted him. We gave him a high station. Wazkur fil kitabi Idris. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concludes. What does Allah say? Allah says in verse number 58, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that ulaika alladhina an'ama Allahu alayhim. These people whom I have mentioned them, our bounties are bestowed upon them. An'ama Allahu alayhim. The way we say, oh Allah, sirat alladhina an'amta alayhim. Keep me on the path of those whom you have bestowed your bounties upon them. I want to be on their path. So Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Then Allah continues to define them. Allah says, these are the people. مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَذُرِّيَّةِ آدَمْ. These are from prophets, and they are from the offsprings of Adam. وَمِمَّنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَ نُوحٍ. Allah says, and these are those that the ark of Nuh bore them, carried them. مِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَإِسْرَائِيلُ. These are from the offsprings of Ibrahim and Israel. Then Allah says, مِمَّنْ هَدَيْنَا وَاجْتَبَيْنَا. These are those that they are guided and they are chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah, this is the same verse which I recited at the beginning of my talk. Then Allah concludes. This is not the end of Surah Maryam. This is verse number 58. Allah says, you know what is the good quality in them? Allah says, إِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِ الرَّحْمَانُ خَرُّوا سُجَّدًا وَبُقِيًّا. They've got a quality inside them. And you know what is that quality? That whenever the verses of Quran, the verses of Rahman, the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are being recited before them, they fall into prostration, they weep, خَرُّوا سُجَّدًا وَبُقِيًّا. And they burst into tears. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is their quality. And this verse which I recited, it has got sunnat sajda. In Quran, there are 10 sunnat sajda. And there are 4 wajib sajda. So this is Surah Maryam, verse number 58. Allah says that whenever the verses of Rahman are being recited before them, they fall into prostration. They fall remorsefulness. They fall remorseful and they burst into tears. Tonight, when we celebrate the birth anniversary of Bibi Zainab, how much do we know about Zainab alayha salam? How much do we know about Bibi Zainab alayha salam? Bibi Zainab's husband is Hazrat Abdullah bin Jafar Tayyar. This was the cousin of Bibi Zainab. And the father-in-law of Bibi Zainab was Jafar Tayyar. Jafar Tayyar, Jafar ibn Abu Talib. He was called Tayyar because the one with wings. He was martyred in the Battle of Muta. His hands were chopped off. And that is why he was given 2 wings and he's flying in the paradise. That is why he's called Jafar Tayyar. This is the father-in-law of Bibi Zainab, alayha salam. Jafar Tayyar, when he was in Makkah, he requested Rasulullah that, Ya Rasulullah, let me go to Habasha. Rasulullah sent him to Abyssinia, to Ethiopia. And he went to Ethiopia. He stayed there. And the husband of Bibi Zainab alayha salam, Hazrat Abdullah, was born in Africa. Many of us are born in Africa. And if we are born in Africa, we come to this part of the world, we are called freshy. Yeah, those who are born in India and Pakistan and in Africa, when we come back here, we are called freshy. Hazrat Abdullah alayhi salam was also born in Africa. He was born in Abyssinia, in Ethiopia. Rasulullah sent Jafar ibn Abu Talib with his wife Asma bint Umays to go to Abyssinia. Why? To protect themselves, to protect their iman, because they were being oppressed and harassed by the polytheists of Makkah. They all went to Abyssinia. During that period of time, 2 sons of Jafar al-Tayyar were born in Abyssinia, and one of them was the husband of Bibi Zainab alayha salam. But when he goes there, he recites, and when the king of Abyssinia, Najashi, was very wise ruler, very fair ruler. He was a good friend of Rasulullah. And eventually, he embraces Islam. He was in Ethiopia when he passed away. Rasulullah recited his namaz-e-janaza in Medina. in Jannatul Baqi. He says that my brother passed away and I will recite his namaz janaza here in Jannatul Baqi. Why? Because of his akhlaq and his ethics, his characters. And then when Jafar bin Abu Talib, the father-in-law of Bibi Zainab, when he goes to Ethiopia, to Abyssinia, and when he meets the king, and when he explains the environment and the atmosphere of Makkah, that how they were oppressed by the policies of Makkah. So the king says to Jafar, that can you recite some verses of your divine book? Coincidentally, he recites Surah Maryam. When he recites Surah Maryam, Jafar ibn Abu Talib recites some parts of Surah Maryam. When he recites Surah Maryam, the king, Najashi, the Abyssinian king, starts to weep. He burst into tears. This is the sign of remorsefulness. He bursted into tears. He wept so much. See, he was a non-Muslim, but he wept. Tears started to flow from his eyes. It is like when we have open day here. People will tell you, why do we have open day? See, the purpose of open day is not to change them into Islam. For them to become Muslims, it is the task of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are supposed just to convey the message. You can't impose and force anybody. To put iman in their heart is the work of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not your work or my work. We just need to convey. Do you know that last year when we had open day, visit my mosque, the non-Muslims, those people of no faith and people of other faith, when they came here, when they saw the verses of Quran, they started weeping. They wept. This is the sign of remorsefulness. This is the sign of humble hearts. Sometimes you could be Muslims, but we have been hearing Quran, but it does not affect us. No, not a single tear from our eyes. We are Muslims, we have brought iman, but no, we don't weep. Our hearts have become hard. The food has affected our hearts. But these are people of other faith, but they weep when they see the verses of Quran. They didn't listen to the verses of Quran, but they just saw the calligraphy kept here of Quran Majid, they started weeping. Same applies to Najashi, the Abyssinian king. Jafar ibn, the father-in-law of Bibi Zainab, when he recites Surah Maryam, he weeps. He weeps so much. And then eventually, he embraces Islam. Ek durud bheje Muhammad aur Ali Muhammad par. I wanted also to talk about the husband of Bibi Zainab alayhi salam, but we don't have enough time. And my time is almost over. And it won't be fair if we don't discuss about Bibi Zainab alayhi salam. About the husband of Bibi Zainab some other time, inshallah. About the husband of Bibi Zainab, and that is Abdullah bin Jafar al-Tayyar. باقی رہا بی بی زینب کے لیے ہمارا ذکر جو ہے تشنا رہ جائے گا اگر خود بی بی زینب کے بارے میں ہم بیان نہ کریں ہاں محترم سامعین زینب کے بارے میں انسان کیا کہیں ایسی شخصیت ہے کہ جو آیت اللہ مرعشی نجفی نے فرمایا اپنے شاگردوں سے کیا کہا آیت اللہ مرعشی نجفی نے آیت اللہ مرعشی نجفی نے اپنے شاگردوں سے کہا کہ جس طریقے سے رسول اللہ شہر علم ہے اور شہر علم کا دروازہ امیر المومنین ہے ویسے اگر امیر المومنین شہر علم ہے تو اس شہر علم کا دروازہ زینب ہے یا دوسرے الفاظ میں یوں کہوں سمجھانے کے لیے کہ اگر انسان کو رسول کے پاس پہنچنا ہے تو علی سے گزرنا پڑے گا تاکہ وہ رسول سے پہنچے اگر انسان کو امیر المومنین کے پاس پہنچنا ہے تو زینب کے ذریعے امیر المومنین سے پہنچنا ہوگا زینب کے ذریعے اسی لیے تو فقط یہ کہنا کافی ہے میرے لیے کہ کس طریقے سے انسان علی کے پاس پہنچے زینب کے ذریعے کیونکہ کوچنگ جو ہے زینب کی علی سے ملی ہے کوفے میں جب خواتین آتی تھی دوبارہ سورہ مریم کوفے میں خواتین آتی تھی تفسیر کے لیے زینب سکھایا کرتی تھی خواتینوں کو جب زینب سکھاتی تھی تو جب سورہ مریم پڑھاتی تھی زینب کاف ہا یا این سواد اس وقت میرے مولا آئے اور مولا امیر المومنین نے زینب سے کہا اے بیٹی یہ بھی کہو ان سے کہ کاف یعنی کربلا ہا یعنی ہلاکت یا یعنی یزید عین یعنی عطش اور سین سواد یعنی صبر کاف ہا یا عین سواد محترم سامین ایک مرجع کہتا ہے کہ ایک مرتبہ میں سرداب میں سامرہ کی زیارت کے لیے گیا اور جب سرداب میں پہنچا سامرہ میں اور وہاں پہ مجھے ندائے غیبی آئے میرے کانوں میں آواز آئے وہ ندائے غیبی یہ تھی کہ اگر میری ظہور کے لیے تم دعا کرنا چاہتے ہو تو خدا سے دعا کرو میری جدہ ماجدہ زینب کے وسیلے سے میرے ظہور کے لیے اگر دعا کرنا چاہتے ہو تو میری جدہ ماجدہ کے وسیلے سے دعا کرو جب زینب علیہ السلام پیدا ہوئی اور جب اس وقت کہتے ہیں کہ رسول اللہ مدینہ میں نہیں تھے بی بی زہرہ علیہ السلام نے امیر المومنین سے کہا کہ یا علی بیٹی ہوئی آپ نام رکھیے اس وقت امیر المومنین نے فرمایا کہ میں نام نہیں رکھ پاؤں گا حتیٰ رسول اللہ آئے جب رسول اللہ آئے تو رسول اللہ نے فرمایا کہ میں بھی نام نہیں رکھوں گا حتیٰ مجھے حکم آئے خدا کی طرف سے جبرائیل امین نازل ہوئے جبرائیل امین نے فرمایا ان اللہ یقرئک السلام ویقول یا حبیبی اجعل اسمہا زینب یا حبیبی یا رسول اللہ خدا نے پہلے جبرائیل کہتے ہیں کہ خداوند کریم نے سلام بھیجا پھر خدا کہتا ہے کہ خدا کا امر ہے کہ ان کا نام رکھا جائے زینب آپ کو پتا ہے کہ کتنی ساری شخصیت ہے بجز علاوہ چودہ معصومین سب کے نام اللہ نے نہیں رکھا بجز چودہ معصومین ایک زینب ہے کہ جس کا نام خدا نے رکھا جبرائیل امین نے کہا کہ یا رسول اللہ ان کا نام زینب رکھا جائے جب ہم نے سورہ مریم کے بارے میں بیان کیا آپ کی خدمت میں تو شاعر اپنے الفاظ میں کہتا ہے کہ فخر مریم جناب زہرا زمان کے لحاظ سے پہلے مریم آئی ہے اسی لیے تو زہرا کو کہا جاتا ہے فخر مریم جناب زہرا فخر زہرا جناب زینب جناب زینب کے بعد جناب زینب جناب زینب جناب زینب جناب زینب کے بعد اور کوئی ثانیہ زینب نہیں ہے ثانیہ زہرا ہے لیکن ثانیہ زینب نہیں ہے کربل کے سفر میں اگر ہمشیر نہ ہوتی کربل کے سفر میں اگر ہمشیر نہ ہوتی تو شام کے بازار میں تقریر نہ ہوتی زینب کے ہی صدقے سے اسلام ہے باقی زینب کے ہی صدقے سے اسلام ہے باقی ورنہ اسلام کی کوئی توقیر نہ ہوتی اسلام کی کوئی قیمت نہ ہوتی آئیں ہم سب مل کے خداوند کریم کے پاس دعا کریں کہ پالنے والے تجھے واسطہ دیتے ہیں زینب کبرا کا شام میں اور دیگر ممالک میں جہاں پہ امن و امان نہیں ہے ان ممالک میں امن و امان قائم کر خدایا دنیا میں زینب کبرا کی زیارت سے مشرف فرما آخرت میں ان کی شفاعت سے محروم نہ کر خدایا تو ہمیں صبر عطا کر اللہم انی اسألک صبرا جمیلا وفرجا قریبا واجرا عظیما بحق زینب بنت امیر المومنین اللہم اغفر للمؤمنین والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات تابع بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات انك مجيب الدعوات انك على كل شيء قدير ہمارے گناہان کبیر اور صغیرہ کو تو بخش دے پالنے ہمارے مریضوں کو تو شفا تو کامل و عاجل عطا فرما جو مقروض ہیں ان کا قرض غیب سے ادا کرنا جو حج و زیارت کے متمنی ہیں ان کو تو حج و زیارت سے مشرف فرما خدایا رسول کا آخری جانشین جو پردے غیب میں ہے ان کی ظہور میں تو تعجیل فرما ان کی ظہور میں تو آسانی فرما افضل السلام بر محمد و آل محمد